guys do to get your pick and roll going again? What are they doing to slow it down? How can you counter?
Well, you know, we'll work at it today. We'll look at some film and see what we can do. But they did a good job hard hedging Tony and trying to take him out of the offense. So that did hurt us. So it's something we'll work on.
Was he as aggressive as he wanted him to be?
He's always aggressive. They deserve credit for their defense.
There's going to be a lot of questions. Everyone wants to talk about the third quarter again, and the third quarter in New Orleans and what the problem seems to be with opening the second half there.
Well, if I knew why we were going to play so badly in the third, we wouldn't have done it last night. So obviously I haven't figured that out.
I know you figured it out, but can you come up with, in New Orleans, why that third quarter seems to start the way it does as opposed to here in those two games here?
Mm-hmm. Manu said that the Flyers got a little too caught up in the officiating. Would you agree with that?
That could, you know, probably to some extent. But that game had to do with New Orleans' defense in the third quarter. I know everybody wants to try to make it something different or pick at this or pick at that, but they deserve credit for that. They did it very well.
I know these are playoff games and naturally playoff games are more physical, but did it seem to you that they really went after Tony hard?
Well, I mean, that's just, you know, it's in the eye of the beholder, I guess. You know, there's no gauge to show you on a scale of 1 to 10, you know, how hard he got hit or this or that. But, you know, one thing we didn't expect is the disparity free throw-wise. We've got to figure out a way to get to the line. You know, Timmy took 18 shots and shot one free throw. And they shot 13 free throws in the third quarter. We shot zero. And I thought we were at the rim as much as they were. So we've got to figure out how to get to the line. Because that's not something you expect. You figure that'll probably even itself out in a game. But that's one of those things that you hope will just be pretty much a wash. And that's not something we expected last night. So that hurt us not getting to the line.
Do you still stand by that delay of game penalty with the team that's shooting the free throws?
Of course, that's the rule. It's not my rule. It's in the rule book. That's how it's done.
Is there any recourse to the?
No, there's never any recourse.
Contact the league, and if so, do they, you know, call back?
Well, I'm sure that the league watched the game. I don't think that anything else has to be done.
I know Manu and the guys talked about treating games 3 and 4 like a game 7. I guess now it's to the point where with game 6 here and. Is that pretty much the same?
That would be a good call. You're right on the money. Amazing that you figured that out.
When we've talked a lot about the disparity of the playoff experience between these two teams, when you're in a situation like this, do you think that's going to be your extensive playoff experience going to be a big help tomorrow night or at this point?
Well, the bottom line is that the better team wins in a 7-game series. I've always said that. So whoever wins the series, it'll be because they're a better team. Anybody else? Okay, have a good day.